So today is day 4 of our 9-day stretch, and we're doing quite well. Got a lot of stuff done yesterday, and still working at it today. Today's a busy day. I've got class tonight, and come along before that, I've got to go pick up some rock and some a compost tumbler someone's going to give me, and I can always appreciate that. We've made arrangements to get some goji berries tomorrow, get some more gooseberries, because we had gooseberries at the other property, and now we're going to get some more gooseberries and plant them about the property. Eventually, we're going to have to stop and plant. And if you can see me amongst these cages, the goal will be to put the chicken coop right here where this raised bed is, a little bit farther away from the fence, and with plenty enough access to get to the back and to the side to collect eggs. We'll make the run along the fence and then right down toward the compost back there in the back. Now, considering this is the west side. This is the side where it's going to get most of the sun. And if I take this, make a sunchoke bed, or take this mulch, spread it out, work it into my soil, it's very clay soil, and loosen that soil up with that compost and with some peat moss and really improve it and its drainage, so the sunchokes can spread, the sunchokes can get big, and they really do a good job providing shade to the chickens and also maybe a little food to munch on as the leaves come through into their run. Down at the other end, I'll leave open for those cool days where they can actually get into the west sun at the setting day and warm themselves up if they need to. But for the hot days, I'm going to have me a little run of sunchokes right through here just to provide that shade. I think it'll work great. But once we put that bed in, we're pretty well going to be dedicated to that sunchoke bed. And we just need to make sure that's where we want it. And I'm pretty sure that that's going to work out just fine. So we're back out looking for resources. It looks like right now we're heading out to get some compost, some more compost, some goji berries, and some other goodies that I've been able to locate in our community. It seems that even though we've been at this for 4 days, it just doesn't seem like we're getting far along as we'd like to. We're doing a lot of prep work. We're doing a lot of resource gathering, and that takes up a lot of time. But it's good to have all that stuff laying around. When you're ready to use it, it'll be there. We potted some more hops this morning, and I'm going to be giving a lot of those away in trade for a lot of different goodies. Well, we sure enough scored. Check this out. Goji berries. Look at this. Whorehound. Isn't that great? It's in a little plastic dude like that. We're going to go home and plant this in the ground, or at least put them in pots until we get ready to plant them in the ground. It's just so many resources that we're picking up, and we just don't have enough time to meet those needs. So, but we're working at it. We're working hard at it. Day 4 of 9, and we're moving on. Once again, an empty bed, no compost, and soon to be full of some pieces of rock and other things that we're going to go over to town to pick up. We also have to go to town to go to class. Today is a school day for me, and I need to go to class this afternoon, test tomorrow. A little anxious about it, but I think we can manage it just fine. The hops, we've planted all the hops, the ones that were soaking in that green garbage can around the other side, and we've got them planted. Hopefully they'll sprout. The other ones are starting to, but very, very small amounts of growth that I've noticed. I've got my new goji berries, and I've got my whorehound. I'm really excited about that whorehound. It looks very interesting, and can't wait to see what it does. So another addition to the homestead. Looks like our raspberries are all coming out, looking very, very well. I'm going to pick up some gooseberries tomorrow, along with some other things, but we really have to get some things accomplished. Last evening when we went out on a photo run, we also doubled it as a rock run, and we were able to pick up these really nice rocks. I really like the ones with the algae growing on them, like right here, if you can see that. Really pretty rocks, lots of cool colors and striations, and I don't know, I like a pretty homestead, plus rock is forever. I mean, that will outlast me, hopefully anyways. You see here how we're having the edging done, and we're going to hold back the bark chips from the wood chips, which will eventually go in this area, looking at probably Thursday, making multiple runs to pick up wood chips, spreading out our bark chips over here. The bed's going to come out a little farther from the house on this side, and there'll be a walk area through the bed and around the bed as well. We did get the hops that were soaking in that water, they're removed. Still haven't got our posts up yet, but hopefully definitely this week. I've got my concrete under that old unsightly wheelbarrow right there, and we don't want to leave that out too long, right? So we'll get busy on that. Anyway, end of, still got a lot of daylight left of this day 4 of 9, and hopefully in the morning we'll pick up our goji berries and get those sunchokes planted. We didn't get them planted, but we got a couple yards of compost out there, and we'll amend the soil once we pick out our definite spot for those sunchokes. And once we picked out that spot, we'll go ahead and lay it in, amend it with both the compost and the peat moss, along with some bone meal, blood meal, and some other good nutrients, some organic nutrients, to make them dudes grow nice and tall and get really big and fat. So other than that, we'll see you tomorrow on day 5 of 9. We're over halfway to our back to work day, but we're getting some things done. We're causing a lot of mess along the way, but we're definitely getting things done. So we'll see you tomorrow on Back to the Homestead.
This.